President Obama did a live interview in the Oval Office with MTV's Sway Calloway. Georgetown students submitted questions. MTV agreed to share its interview with us. Mr. Obama was asked about a range of issues important to young voters, from jobs to student loan debt to climate change. And President Obama addressed those topics and also tried to connect with young voters with some personal details. One isn't exactly a tough interview in any way. There weren't a lot of follow-up questions. Take a look.
We've seen artists like Bob Marley, Bob Dylan, Public Enemy's Chuck D, Rage Against the Machine have all made popular music that inspired and informed. What artists do you feel today uphold that tradition and how?
You know, it's an interesting question. We haven't seen as much directly political music. You know, I think the most vibrant musical art form right now over the last 10, 15 years has been hip-hop. You just mentioned Bob Marley. I mean, I can remember when I was in college, you know, listening and you know, not agreeing with his whole philosophy necessarily, but raising my awareness about how people outside of our country were thinking about the struggles for jobs and dignity and freedom. You know, a lot of the music of the 70s, there was a sense of engagement in what was happening with the anti-war movement and what was happening with respect to the civil rights movement. And so I would hope that, you know, we're going to see more of that.
Okay.
You know, because young people, you know, they communicate in a lot of different ways, and everything moves so fast today that you can set the world on fire, you know, in a positive way, just through, you know, a message that, you know, goes through the internet in a way that it used to. Yeah, I had to go buy an album or a cartridge, you know.
Cartridge.
Yeah, you know, that's old school.
Some 45 million 18 to 29-year-olds are eligible to vote in the November 6 election. They also have the lowest turnout rates. In 2008, President Obama captured 66% of the youth vote. Joining me now is MTV News correspondent Andrew Jenks, who talked to Georgetown students after President Obama's interview. CNN political reporter Peter Hamby and Republican strategist Kristen Soltis also joined me. Andrew, you've been visiting college campuses as much as you did today, talking to young voters. What are you detecting in terms of enthusiasm this time around?
You know, I think there is a sense of this has been a bit of a bad breakup from 4 years ago, not necessarily with President Obama, but just with government at large. But I think it's on us to ask questions, to make sure that our friends get involved. And I have seen, as you know, we've gotten closer to Election Day, a lot of young people are starting to talk about it more. And so, I mean, that's been encouraging.
Kristen, in 2008, President Obama won 66% of the under 30 vote, a 34% margin of victory over John McCain. You say the president's numbers are high this time around, but certainly not as high as 2008.
Not at all. You had a recent poll come out that Harvard released where he had a 19-point advantage. It's still a wide margin, but not nearly the margin that he had 4 years ago. And if he doesn't hold young voters to a significant margin that's close to those 08 numbers, it's going to be really tough for him to put together his majority coalition to try to win this election.